Good morning, students. All well? Good. Yesterday I have discussed about the resources, and I hope you have learned the meaning of resources with example at your home. So, dear students, write the same in your notebook. When you will come to the school, I will check it. Today, I will continue the same topic, that is resources. Students, you know, the human needs and wants are never same. They are not uniform. From the ancient times to till now, the human needs are always changed. For example, if we're talking about the ancient times, people fulfilled only their basic needs. Only basic needs such as food, shelter, clothing, etc. They fulfill their only basic needs by using some natural resources. In ancient times. But now, pygmies is a name of tribes. They live in Africa. They use some natural resources to fulfill their basic needs. It means they use flower, roots, they hunt the animal to fulfill their basic needs. It means they are also dependent on natural resources. But nowadays, it means if I am talking about the modern society or advanced society, they fulfill their needs. They fulfill their different needs by using different resources. Now, if we're talking about the modern society, in modern society, they fulfill their different needs. For example, if they are using the water. Nowadays, water they use for the navigation purpose. Water they use for the generating hydroelectricity. They use water for the irrigation also, and so on. So what I am talking to you, nowadays the people use water to fulfill their different needs. Same resources are used by the people in ancient time for the drinking purpose only. After the passage of time, they use water for the irrigating field. But nowadays, the needs are changed and they use water for different purposes. So, my dear students, I hope you have understood about the needs of the common peoples, which are changed time to time and place to place. Tomorrow, I will discuss about the factors of realization and resources. Thank you and have a nice day.